Students, welcome back to the online classes. This is the second session of the chapter Simple Electric Circuits. In the previous session, we have learnt about battery and bulb. Why we are learning about this? Why? Because we are studying about the torchlight. We want to know about the torchlight. So, in order to know about the torchlight, we have seen about the battery. Why? Because it plays an important role in the torchlight, and the bulb is also a main part of the torchlight. And later we have seen that what is an electric circuit. So, what is an electric circuit? Electric circuit is a closed path. Electric circuit is a closed path between batteries and bulb. Electric circuit is a closed path between batteries and bulb. So, here this is the connection between these two wires. Here I have considered 1, 2, 3, 4 wires. So, these wires will provide a path for the electricity. When you connect the bulb and the battery with these wires, it provides a path for electricity. If there is any disconnection will be there. If there is any disconnection, the flow of electricity will not be done. Path for electricity, there will be no flow of electricity, and hence we will call this as, this is our wires tied at here. So, flow of electricity, what we have learned, the flow of electricity is called as, current. It is very important definition. The flow of electricity is called as current. What is current? The flow of electricity is called as current. And the path, these wires will provide a path for electricity. The electricity will move like this. So, will completely move like this. So, if there is any gaps, what will happen? The bulb does not close. If there is any gap, the bulb does not close. We will call this as open circuit. We will call, why? Because it is not closed. There is a gap here. This is an open circuit. Open. If there is any gap, it is an open circuit. If there is any gap, it is a open circuit. It is an open circuit. If it is a, otherwise, if there is no gaps, it is a closed circuit. If there is no gaps are there, it is a closed circuit. So, the bulb will glow when the circuit is closed. When the circuit is closed, now it is open or closed, it is a open circuit. Why? Because there is a gap here. If you connect this gap, then this is an open circuit. This is an closed circuit. If there is any gap, open circuit. If the circuit is completely closed, then it is a closed circuit. So, now we have learnt about batteries and bulbs that consist in the torchlight. And what does the torchlight consist other than bulb and batteries? The torchlight consists of a switch. The torchlight consists of a switch. So, now let us learn about electric switch. Now, let us learn about electric switch. Electric switch. So, let us make an arrangement. What will happen? What is the purpose of the switch? The purpose of the switch is to on and off the electric devices. To on the bulb and to off the fan. In such a way, electric switch is used for the on and off purposes of the electric appliances. Electric switch is used for on and off to on and use it for on and off of the electric appliances, on and off of the electric appliances. Electric appliances means it may be fans, bulbs, fridges, TVs or etc. Everything will comes under electric appliances. Everything will comes under appliances. To know about the function of the switch, this is the use of the switch. What is the use? To on and off the electric appliances. And let us learn about what is the, let us see about what is the function of the switch. So, to know about this, let us consider, let us make an arrangement with the battery and bulb. So, consider a battery, consider a battery and connect a wire with positive end of the battery to one terminal of the battery, one terminal of the bulb, to one terminal of the bulb. So, from the positive terminal of the battery, I have connected to the one terminal of the bulb, and connect this another terminal of the bulb to a nail fixed on a cardboard. So, let us take a cardboard. I have taken a cardboard, it may be thermocol or a cardboard. So, this is a cardboard and a nail is fixed to this, a small nail is fixed to this, and connect this red colored wire to this nail, connect the red colored wire to this nail and place another nail here. So, and from the other end of the battery, take another wire and connect it to the other nail. Now, place a safety pin here. Safety pin, you know, I think. So, let us say this is the safety pin. So, this is the cardboard and these are the nails you have to use, small nails will be available, and this is the safety pin. So, if the safety pin is, now the bulb glows or not? The bulb does not glow. Why? Because there is an open, here two wires are not connected to each other. There is a gap between these two wires, hence the bulb does not glow. So, if you attach this safety pin to the other nail, now what happens? Now the bulb will glow. So, here safety pin acts as a switch. What the safety pin is doing here, if you keep the safety pin like this, what will happen? Again the bulb will goes off. If safety pin touches this nail, again the bulb will glows on. What this safety pin was doing? So, if you touch the safety pin to this nail, the circuit will be converted into closed circuit. If you remove that safety pin, then what will happen? The circuit will be open. So, this is the function of the switch. What is the function of the switch? When you on the switch, it will convert into a closed circuit. When you off the switch will convert into a open circuit. So, the function of the switch is to open the circuit and to close the circuit. If the switch is in on position, then the circuit is closed. When the switch is in the off position, the circuit is open. Open circuit means gaps will be there. Closed circuit means no gaps between the battery and bulb. So, the function of the switch is function of the switch. So the function of the switch is to, the function of switch is, the function of switch is to open the circuit and close the circuit. To open the circuit and to close the circuit. If switch is on, if switch is on, the circuit is closed. If switch is on, the circuit is closed. That means there is no gap between the, there will be no gaps between the battery and bulb. If switch is off, if switch is off, the circuit is open. So, this is the function of the switch. What does the switch make? The switch makes the circuit to be closed or to be open. It will converts. If the switch is on, the circuit is closed, so that it allows the electricity to pass through the electric components, to pass through the bulb. If the switch is off, the circuit is open. When the circuit is open, the electricity does not flow from battery to the bulb. So, this is the function of the switch and this is the purpose of the switch. So, we have learnt about electric switch. Now, let us look into the torch light. So, the torch light consists of a cylindrical shaped barrel, hollow cylindrical barrel. So, the torch light consists of a cylindrical shaped hollow barrel. Hollow means it is an empty, it consists of an empty barrel, empty cylindrical shaped barrel. At one end of the barrel is closed with a cap, with a screwed cap, with a screwed cap. So, this is an empty barrel and arrangement will be there. So, this is cylindrical barrel, this is the part where the light will comes out, and this empty barrel is for to insert the batteries here, to insert batteries. So, this is the battery, negative, positive, and again one more battery will be there, negative, positive. And this battery is directly connected, one of the batteries directly connected to one terminal of the bulb, one terminal of the bulb. So, this is the bulb, and the bulb which is used in torch light, one of the terminal will be at the downside and other terminal will be situated here. So, whenever we are explaining about the structure of the bulb, we have seen that one terminal will be at the bottom of the bulb and the other terminal will be at top of the metal cap, top of the metal cap. So, here one terminal is situated and another terminal is situated here. So, the wires will come from, one wire will come from, so this, from this negative terminal of the battery, a wire will be attached here, attached to the switch here, attached to the switch. So, this switch will be in contact. So, if you press the switch in the forward direction, if you move the switch in the forward direction, then the connection will be obtained. here you can observe a small gap. Here you can observe a small gap when you move the switch in the forward direction. When you move the switch in the forward direction, then the light will glows out. So the battery, the torchlight structure will be looks like this. So how the battery torchlight looks like? So we are learning about torchlight. So the torchlight consists of a hollow cylindrical barrel for batteries. So the hollow space is included in the torchlight for to insert the batteries. So here one battery is directly attached to the terminal of the bulb. One terminal of the battery is attached to one of the terminals of the bulb. And another terminal of bulb, here one terminal is directly attached to the battery and another terminal is connected to other end of the battery through a switch. So this is the switch. So another terminal of bulb is attached to other end of the battery through a switch. These switches will be available in different ways. The functioning of the different switch was different. For example, if you observe the TV switch, it will be press like switch. So if you press it once, it will off. If you press it once, it will be on. So similarly, the different types of switches will be available here. So I have drawn here a switch which has to move in the forward direction. If you move the switch in the forward direction, then the circuit will be closed and allows the light to glow up. And if you drag the switch in the backward direction, then the light will be off. So, and one more important point is, if here the battery should be connected like this only. How here the positive terminal of the battery, the positive terminal of the battery is connected to negative terminal of another battery. Here the positive terminal of one battery is connected to negative terminal of second battery. If you think this is the first battery and this is second battery, positive terminal of first battery is connected to negative terminal of second battery. So if you connect like this, so the positive and positive are connected here, so the bulb doesn't lights up. So the order of the position of the battery plays also very important role in the torchlight. So if you place the positive and positive terminal in contact, the bulb doesn't close. Or otherwise, if you place negative and negative terminals here like this in contact, then also the bulb doesn't close. So the bulb, the battery lights, the battery's position in the bulb must be like this. The positive terminal of first battery should be in contact with negative terminal of the second battery. Then only it will be lights, it will be glows, then only the light will glows. If there is any gap, between the batteries, then also the light doesn't glows. If there is any damages in this electric wires, then also light doesn't glows. So what could be the reasons if the torch light is damaged? What could be the reasons for that? So what could be the reasons? The position of the batteries may be different. So we will call this position of the batteries, this type of position of batteries is called as series connection of batteries. How, what is the series connection of batteries? Positive terminal of one battery is connected to negative terminal of other battery. We will call this as series connection of batteries. If the connection was not like this, the torch light doesn't glows. So this is one other reason is also there. Sometimes if you observe, there will be some defaults in the bulbs also. So what happens if the filament is fused out? Fused means burns out. If the filament in the bulb, sometimes the filament in the bulbs will fuses, fused. Fused means it will be burns out. The filament will burns out. So why? Because when electricity is flowing, through the wires into the filament, how the bulb works, how the bulb gives light is, here the filament, when the current is passing through this filament, this will heat up, this filament will heats up because of the flow of current. If you touch the bulb, you can observe the heat that is obtained by the current. So because of this heat, the filament in the bulb will heats up and gives light and glows up. So this will gives the, in this way this current produces heat. So that's why if you hold the bulb, you will find some heat on the glass chamber. So sometimes because of this heat, sometimes what happens, this filament will burn out and a gap will be obtained, because of this gap, the bulb, the torch light may not be works. So this is about torchlight we have learned. So we have seen about batteries, bulb, and we have already seen about electric switch. What is the function of the electric switch? The function of the electric switch is to make the circuit closed or to make the circuit open. If the switch is in on position, then the circuit will be closed so that the electricity will flow through the circuit. If the switch is off, the circuit is open and it doesn't allows the electricity to pass through that. So now we will use only particular materials in the wires. We don't use any plastic materials inside the wire. There is only a plastic coating presented on the wire. If you open the wire, you will find a copper material. We will call these as copper materials. The material that present inside the wire is copper. So why we are using only copper? There is some coating presented on this wire. It is made with some plastic. So you cannot use any threads in the place of those wires. Why? Because only some materials will allow the light to, allow the current to pass through it. Let us make a connection between the battery and bulb. So just make a simple electric circuit. So you have considered a battery and you have connected this battery to the bulb through the wires. So if you connect the bulb to the battery with wires, with these wires are made up of copper wire, copper material. These wires are made up of copper. If you replace these wires with a thread, if you replace this wire with a thread, what will happen? The bulb doesn't glow. Why? Because all substances doesn't allow the electricity. If you connect a wire, you can, there will be a flow of electricity, there will be a flow of electricity from battery to the bulb. If you connect thread, it doesn't allow the electricity, it doesn't allow the electricity to pass through it, to pass through it. So depending upon the electric nature, the substances are divided, the substances are classified into two types. One is conductors and another one is insulators. So depending on electric nature, the substances are classified into two types. One is conductor. What are conductors? That will conduct the current. That means which allows the current, the substances which allows the current to pass through it are called as conductors. The substances, all the substances doesn't allow the electricity to pass through it. So the substances which allows the current to pass through it, are called conductors. And the so what are the examples of conductor? So examples: iron, copper, aluminium, platinum, silver. Mostly all the metals will conduct electricity. Silver, these are the metals. So these metals will conduct electricity. You can observe the copper substance. You can observe the copper substance in your home wires that is using in your homes. You can observe this aluminium made wires on the electric poles. If you observe the wires near the electric poles, those wires are made up of aluminium wires. We will call those wires as high tension wires. So okay. And the substances which doesn't allow the current to pass through it are called insulators. The substances that doesn't allow the current to pass through it are called insulators. Example: plastic, rubber, clothes, pure water doesn't allow the current. Whereas impure water, if there are some impurities are there, salt water will conduct the electricity. Pure water doesn't conduct the electricity. Pure water means rainwater. Rainwater doesn't conduct the electricity. Rainwater means you have to collect the water before it reaches to the ground. After reaching to the ground, if you collect it, that is dirty water. So the dirty water will also conduct the electricity. Pure water means you have to collect the rainwater before reaching the ground only. So this is about conductors and insulators. With this session was completed. Thank you.